We're so glad you're here today, and it's amazing that we had this kind of a turnout on a Saturday morning when there's so many sports events, but we're just thrilled to see you all. We're so glad to have a very unique performer, someone who's international. We didn't ever have a fall enrichment or a spring enrichment with anybody that was from another country, so this is quite special. Juan Ospina is from Colombia, South America, and he's currently a student at TCU working on his artist diploma. And his teacher is a longtime friend of mine, Helen Blackburn. Some of you old-timers have probably seen us perform together, Helen and I. We've played many times. I think we've known each other since 1985, so I can't count back that far, but that's a lot of years. So she suggested that we have Juan come and play for you, and he's a multi-talented person with lots of different instruments to show you today. And so let's give him our best welcome.
I'm going to start with this flute. Okay, I like a lot the flutes because I like the sound. You produce the sound with your air, and it's like come from yourself. Like so, and in like I think the flute is a really old instrument. Maybe the pharaohs, like the voice, and then the percussion, and then I think the flutes, and they are super close, like around the world. They didn't meet each other, but they had the same instrument, like super close. So, Helen, can you please talk a little bit about this? Shakuhachi, this is a flute from Japan.
Yeah. So it's good. This is the Shakuhachi, and sometimes it's called the singing bamboo, and it's used to evoke the sounds of nature, so wind and animals and the human voice, and there are some Buddhist monks who use the Shakuhachi to use as a breathing meditation, and the word Shakuhachi actually is just a measurement. It's like saying that instead of Juan's name being Juan, it would be that he's 6 foot two or whatever. So his name would be 6 foot two. But in this case, Shakuhachi is like however many meters that is. That's the Japanese word for the length. And it's made out of a piece of bamboo. And there are actually several different lengths of Shakuhachi, but I think the word came from what the original one was. So he's going to play a little bit of Japanese influence Shakuhachi, and then he's going to improvise on it. And it's very difficult to play. You can maybe show them how you produce the tone. Sure.
The flutes and were really important for the people to have connection with God or the God that they had because different cultures. So they use the sound also to communicate with the other place. Thank you. This flute is just caucana flute. They used to make the flute a little bit shorter, but I met the guy that made the flute, and I wanted one big, so he made for me the flute. I'm going to play. This is a flute that they use in the Amazonas, in Colombia. Their name is Muinane.
The tribe
is Muinane. And also, this flute is used in the Pacific from Colombia. So I'm going to start with a song from the Amazonas.
Improvisation.
Thank you.
for this flute.
Thank you.
bandolita. Is bandola is a instrument like string. So they made the piece for flute and it's like ground.
Thank you. Japanese flute. Mm-hmm. Is there a reed inside the flute? It sounds like an oboe.
Yes, it's like, okay, it's
a double
like
reed?
Metal.
Oh, metal.
Metal, and it's like this, a piece with a hole, and a little piece of metal here, so the vibration make some...
Because sometimes it sounds like a harmonica.
Yeah, harmonica.
And sometimes it